Hello there, everybody. It's been a hot minute since my voice was last heard on my channel, but today I wanted to experiment with something a bit new. I did try this in the past on one of my old channels, but I really want to try it again. This is going to be a speed paint with commentary. I will be talking about what I'm currently doing, as in going through my process as you see it on the screen, just to sort of explain what's actually going on in my head as I'm drawing. And I think a video like this is particularly interesting when it comes to designing a character rather than just drawing a pre-made character, as I'm doing in this video here. Because when you're designing a character, you know, you try so many things, you experiment, you might not like some things, you try different things until you end up with the result you're happy with. So anyways, enough of my rambling, let's actually talk about what's going on here. So, as you saw a bit ago, I was experimenting with the eyelashes and the ears, but I decided I didn't like a couple of the things I was going for and scrapped them. I decided I wanted to work with a worm. Yes, that's what this species is called. That's inspired by a big cat of some sort, which is why I ended up going for the little fluffy rounded ears. But as you can see right now, I didn't want to stop at something simply inspired by a big cat. I really, really wanted to incorporate wings somehow, but especially moth wings. That's also why I gave it that fluffy back mane, because, well, moths are poofy. Back onto the topic of the wings though, Luna moths are my personal favorite moths. I get a lot of them in the summer where I live, and I think they're just beautiful. So the shape of these wings is heavily inspired by the Luna moth, as you could tell from my reference picture. Right now, I'm just adding fluff in more places to make everything more consistent, but little did I know, things are about to take a turn for the worse. You see, I had had a headache all day on the day I actually designed this worm. It was minor, I was able to ignore it pretty easily and continue on with my drawing, but it was unfortunately the start of something much bigger. But anyways, back to the video. Right now, I'm adding flowers, taking inspiration from the shape of daisies in my head. I didn't actually have a reference. And spreading them throughout the worm. I didn't really have a reason for doing this. I just thought it would look cute. I also changed up their sizes and angles so they wouldn't all look exactly the same. I personally think it looks much better that way. Then I resized the entire character by scaling it down. This was because I wanted this drawing to replicate the line art style that Wermz have, and a smaller canvas size would help make that effect more easily achievable. Here's an example of what an official worm looks like. To clarify, worms aren't an open or closed species. I know that's what I'm making it sound like, but it's kind of weird and hard to explain what exactly they are. They're kind of like collectibles, I guess? I'll leave a link in the description if you want to learn more, but anyways. Personally, I don't like this pen. After messing with it for a while, I started to get a bit frustrated that the lines weren't turning out how I wanted them to. I think the line art would have turned out a lot better if I moved the sketch to my computer, onto Paint Tool Sai, and used my hard pixel brush to achieve the same effect to a much more successful degree. Even right now, you can see me selecting all the areas around the line art and inverting it. That's me filling in the pixels that ended up being see-through. The brush was not as hard as I would have wanted it to be. And the variation between thin and thick lines isn't the best either. And finally, we're on to coloring. Oh boy, coloring. I'm not gonna lie to you guys, it was a bad time. I went in with literally no idea of what I wanted, just mashing colors together like, let's see if this works. And my headache was getting a lot worse by this point, but I was determined, so I kept going anyways. The colors aren't that bad right now, though. Right now, it's kind of just very natural leopard colors. Yeah, that fucking lasted maybe like 5 minutes. Even though the colors drastically changed later on, I always enjoyed this pattern, so I ended up keeping it. Leopards are hella cute. Oh, but the wings. Here we go with these ugly ass vagina shit smear looking ass wings. I love pink and brown together, but I find that it's really hard to pull off in my personal opinion. The shades have to be just right, and brother, this is not it! This is not it at all. What even are these wings? I also just hated the pattern on the wings too. I thought it looked so ugly, dude. And once again, I was getting frustrated. Thankfully, and you're never gonna believe this, but I ended up keeping this pattern on the wings. I ended up making it work, which you'll see later on. At this point though, something like that seems like a miracle. Marshall, shush. And now, we begin with the full recolor. This is the good shit, but let me tell you. By this point, my brain felt like it was going to explode, my guts were turning into mush, and my butt cheeks wanted to leave my body after being so tired they'd gone numb. As I said before, this was no ordinary headache. This, my friends, was the start of COVID. I just happened to start feeling the symptoms right as I was recording this speed paint. Very inconvenient timing. At the start of the drawing, I was all good, just a minor headache. But by this point, dude, I was just ready for it to be over. I'm so damn stubborn. I don't know when to quit, even if it's better for my health. But anyways, as you can see, we're already seeing major improvements with the colors, and the design only continues to improve right up until the end. I don't think I've ever used a palette like this before, and honestly, I love it so much. And here, we are approaching the end of the speed paint. This is the finished design, after what felt like endless hours of work. I can safely say that I am extremely proud of the way this character turned out though, even despite the issues I have with the line art. I can't wait to make it an official Wermz at some point in the future. I mean, I can't make it myself though, because I'm not a Wermz artist. Damn, that's really sad. I should totally be hired to fix this glaring issue.